Hey there, how you doing tonight? Happy Saturday, and cheers to my smidge. Cheers, everybody.
This is how you should socially, what is it, socially distance yourself.
We are socially distancing, but not from each other.
No, not at all.
No, not at all, especially this afternoon.
It is Saturday.
Did you see my post about free premium Pornhub?
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Oh. I need to look that up.
During everything that's going on. So, we are hanging out. I'm going to play some music and entertain y'all, you fine folks. And we're going to take questions. We're going to do question and answers. We're going to hang out. First of all, make sure that you let us know where you're watching from. Hey, Ashley, my little sister.
Hi, Ashley. The balcony misses you. Can you smell the smoked ribs?
Oh, I'm smoking ribs right now.
I'm smoking them right now. Can you smell them? I'm gonna send the scent.
Remember that, Ash? Yes. So, I mean, we'll get right into like coronavirus stuff. My little sister, who is on here and watching, she is a super nurse at Butler Hospital in Rhode Island, and she's already working. I mean, she already works her ass off, works very, very hard, and I'm sure that it's going to get even more challenging for her. So, shout out to my little sister, who is just down. We miss you.
We miss you, Ashley.
And we miss telling stories about Michelle. I invited her.
Oh, you invited her on here? She probably isn't.
What's up, Casey? How you doing? Where are you watching from? Well, we'll save some ribs for you, Ash. Thank you very much, Jody. I really appreciate it. We really appreciate it. What we're doing is awesome. So this is what we're doing. I don't want to overstate it, but I basically want to come on here, play songs, and hang out with everybody to foster a feeling of community and to have a group of people that we can basically hang out with, because we're not really going anywhere. And I know that a lot of people have to stay home. Ashley's like, oh my god, Shell. And then like laughing, smiley face. That's hilarious. And look.
I can see. Oh my gosh.
So
we hear that noise every day.
Yeah, we do. Hey, Chris, how you doing? Alright, so those are the rules, man. Like, ask us any questions if you want to talk about something. Not that we know anything, but we can tell you.
Oh, you know lots of stuff, buddy.
I do. I know.
I probably know more, but you know a lot of stuff.
That's not even close to being true. I know that I love my smidge.
Oh, I love you too. You're so cute.
All right. We can tell you what we're doing for this whole crazy, 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 crazy times. And just trying to stay positive and do as much as we can and stay healthy and happy. So, yeah, I mean, if you don't want to hang out, I'll just play like half songs or something.
Just hang out for a little bit.
So, I'm going to play, and can you see the screen?
I'm blind. Sing your new song. Ooh, yeah, new song.
Which new song?
The Corona or Rockstar?
Let us know which new song. Oh yeah, I forgot to put that in the notes. Place requests, and if I know it, or if it's something of mine, then I'll play it.
Corona.
Okay. Where do I have that?
What do you need?
I need that song.
Is it in the black book?
It might be.
I'll look for it.
Okay. So, all right, we're gonna look for it.
Thank you.
Cassandra. Rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Hey, mama, rock me. Rock me, mama, like the wind and the rain. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Love you too, Ash. Be safe, stay healthy. Please try not to work too hard. I know you have your work cut out for you. And we are very, 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 very proud of you.
Yes, Ashley. Is she leaving?
Yeah.
Bye, Ashley.
Thanks, Cassandra.
Up in New England, I was born to be a fiddle and an old time string band. The Bay plays a guitar, a big band, and now North Carolina winters keep getting me down. Lost my money playing poker, so I had to leave town. I ain't turning back to live that old life no more. So rock me, mama, like a wagon wheel. Rock me, mama, any way you feel. Rock me, mama, like a southbound train. Hey, hey, mama, rock me. Hey, hey, mama, rock me. Hey, hey, mama, rock me. Hey, hey, mama, rock me.
All right, yay. Oh, and do me a favor and make sure you share this post. Share, 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 Sunny and Share. That is on the right, the bottom right-hand side. One more thing, there's also digital tip jars in the description of this post. So seeing that all my gigs were canceled, if you want to throw some money our way, that would be great. So I wrote a thank you very much for sharing, Chris. I've got to tell you, mis cielos azules in Spanish, do you speak it? Sí, porque yo hablo español.
Y hablas muy bien, mi amor.
Sí, muchas gracias. Pero no, no está más bueno que tú. How is that?
Está casi perfecto.
Okay.
Sí.
How long did it take me to learn that song? I wrote that song. It took me as long as it took me to write it, which was probably, I don't know, like 4 hours. Thank you, Terry. Tip jar tipping coming right up. I love you. Thank you so very much. We really appreciate it, and we appreciate y'all hanging out with us. We appreciate everybody being positive and helping each other out in these very, very, very crazy, scary, difficult, trying times. We have friends now that are, you know, going through a lot of stuff already. Besides this, and so we're trying to my message keeps being be nice to each other, be patient with each other, help each other, and we'll all get through this. We'll get through this better than ever. You know, it's almost like, I mean, I hate to say it, but it's like being, not that I've ever been somewhere where there's a war, but it's like being at war, and we're gonna have to all be very strong and resilient to get through this stuff. I mean, it's not a joke, it's not a movie, it's reality.
Yeah, and people are still going through real life things that have nothing to do with this, so they have to deal with that on top of this situation.
Make sure that they can hear you. Just you know. Sometimes, like on the microphone, isn't that great? So, what I'm gonna do is I'm going to play a song that I wrote.
Smell good.
Last year. Thank you. Apparently, I smell good. We are all in this together. Exactly, Jody. So, another thing that we've been doing is we've been really working out a lot, going out in the sun a lot, going to the beach, because we're lucky enough, fortunate enough to live at the beach, but getting as much fresh air as possible, staying away from people, and really trying to seriously stay as healthy as possible. I mean, if you're gonna be home and stuck at home, now's the time to start a fitness routine, and get out. Even if it's cold, get out, get some sun. No matter what it takes, get some sun. Sun helps, vitamin D helps your immune system and all that stuff. I used to be a personal trainer, so I know of what I speak. So this is a song that I wrote about Corona commercials. Remember back in the day, like 3 weeks ago, when Corona only meant cold beer, hot beaches, vacations, getaways, no cares in the world, and those really, really cool Corona commercials? Well, I wrote a song about it. Here you go. What's up, Jody Santangelo? Okay. All right, here's my song, Corona. Michelle in New Hampshire. So what you say, you pack that bikini, the little blue one that drives me crazy. Roll out fast for a little change of scenery. Get there fast, take a beach bar lazy. I wanna live a Corona commercial. Wave on wave with you by my side. Sunset is all pink and it's purple. I wanna live a Corona commercial. All right, I wrote this bridge, and I love it. Throw caution to the wind, there's only one life to live. Molly on the radio, barely dressed with nowhere to go. Quiero vivir commercial de Corona, en los Andes a tu lado, el cielo estar azul y rosada. Quiero vivir commercial de Corona. I wanna live a Corona commercial. Wave on wave with you by my side. Sunset is all pink and it's purple. I wanna live a Corona commercial. What's up, Ray? Shout out from Miami Beach. Commercial de Corona, en las andas con tu lado, el cielo estará azul y rosada. Quiero vivir un commercial de Corona. Awesome. All right, thank you, Ray, and thank you, Jody. So does anybody have any questions for either one of us? Like, is Smidge getting more wine? That's, oh, that's a good question. Yeah, thank you for asking that. Who's that? Tim Sharon.
Do you need more wine? I understand. Nice. That's empty. I understand how that happens.
So, yeah, man, we're hanging out with everybody, with all of y'all, and, you know, maybe have a little drink with us. We hardly ever drink anymore, but we figured that... Thank you very much, Jody. We figured that, why not? And, you know, this, it's funny because I never do this out here, out on our balcony, which is absolutely gorgeous. And so this is a nice thing that that came out of us having to stay home. Jody Santangelo says, hi, Smidge. So everybody give Smidge a shout out in the comments, please. Yes, Michelle, Smidge is getting me a drink.
Hi, Jody.
Thank you, dear. What town are you in again? Heather, we are in Miami Beach. The beach is right there. Let's show you the view a little bit. Oh, shit.
Spill your wine, Betty.
No, I dropped the song.
Oh, I'll get it.
So, right there is the park, and the ocean is right past that. And this is South Beach, basically. Lisa Lardy says, hi, Smidge.
Hi, Lisa.
How's the weather? Jody is phenomenal. It's like a nice summer day in the middle of the winter. We went to the beach today. Went to the beach. Did we go to the beach twice?
No.
You're messing everything up.
I'm sorry.
But we went for a run or something, or a walk.
We went for a mini walk on the beach, and then we're gonna go again tonight after this.
Yeah. So that's one thing that we're doing with all this stuff going on is we're working out a lot and eating healthy, and we stocked up on some stuff. We've been getting it. A little bit, little by little, here and there. Make sure we have enough. And so we'll be good to go. Right on, Jody, right on. Jody Foster says, sup, Smidge.
Sup.
Can you ask Smidge to stand on her head?
He can, but that doesn't mean
I have no idea what the hell that means to you.
No.
All right, Lisa, you're freaking weird.
I don't know what that means.
Jody's supposed to go on a cruise in September. Yeah, come and visit us. As long as this all passes. Heather Page is down here. Oh, wow. Tell her to say hi. Yeah, we are right here in the middle of South Beach. Basically, Ocean Drive is right there. So we are in the epicenter of awesomeness. Right, Smidge?
Exactly. We were supposed to fly out to New Orleans today. Actually, we're supposed to be leaving right now, but since business conference was canceled, we are here with you guys.
Cassandra, I don't know that song, unfortunately. So we'll have to pick a different one. What am I playing? I need
Drinking About You.
Oh.
Is it right here?
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, here's a song that I haven't played in forever. And we used to play this in our sets all the time. It's we did not release it on any of the records, though. But this is for y'all that are hanging in, maybe having a drink or two with us. And this is a little song that I wrote. It's like a little story song about a guy that gets in a little argument with his girlfriend. So he goes out with his friends. And the whole idea behind the song is when I get to thinking, then I get to drinking about you because you're a pain in my butt.
Did you say you're a pain in my butt like me?
Yeah. You are a pain in my butt.
Thank you.
You bet, Michelle. Whoa! Somebody just... Cassandra, I'm going to play that song because... That's so funny. I just went through a bunch of my stuff. I'm cleaning my room in my studio as well. So yes, yes, wait, John Mellencamp, Wild Nights. And I went, was just going through stuff.
I think I just saw it.
Oh, did you?
Yeah.
Oh, maybe it's still over there. Maybe I need to.
I'll get it.
Grab it. And I was going through stuff and I was like, man, I need to play that song. So I will definitely do that. Smidge is going to go grab it. Oh, hey, Mark, yeah. Don't get parking tickets down here in South Beach. It's expensive. Do I know Hunter Hayes personally? I do, actually. I don't know any of his songs, but, huh? You want to hear a Hunter Hayes story? I worked at one of his concerts in introducing all the acts. So at an arena, I introduced Lauren Elena and Kelly Pickler and Hunter Hayes. But before that, like a year and a half before that, we met him in Guitar Center, and he was talking to me a lot at Guitar Center. I think he wanted to be my friend. Let's see. All right, so here's the song about drinking. Cheers. Here's the other thing. I have a policy. Me, myself, and my band, we never, ever, 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 I don't allow people to drink before our shows or on stage. I never, ever, ever, ever drink on stage. Maybe like once in 3 years at a if we play like a small bar or something. So this will be different. I'll be actually performing for people and having a glass of wine at the same time. Drink About You or Wild Nights? I'll do a little bit of Drink About You, then I'll do Wild Nights. There's a toothpaste on the sink, I'm trying hard to think what it is I messed up all this time. Out with my friends and your little angry text, my mind spins into overdrive. When I get to thinking, then I get to drinking about you. Girl, you drive me crazy, you know I love you, baby, I do. Your thoughts start racing, my heart starts pacing, trying to wash away these blues. I start drinking. My foot goes right up to my mouth, all twisted up, a hurricane of stuff. The conversation heads right to the south. So when I get to thinking, then I get to drinking about you. Girl, you drive me crazy, you know I love you, baby, I do. My thoughts start racing, heart stops pacing, trying to wash away these things. Start drinking about you. Then I get to thinking, then I get to drinking about you. Girl, you drive me crazy, you know I love you, baby, I do. My thoughts start racing, my heart starts pacing, trying to wash away these blues. Start drinking about you. Start drinking about you. Start drinking about you. Drinking about you. Right, cheers. Let me know where you're watching from. Thank you for the thumbs up, Cassandra. What's up, Jody? Let me know who else is watching and where you're watching from. If you enjoy anything that I do, then be kind enough to throw some money in the digital tip jars. They are on the description, or you definitely don't have to tip. Oh, well, tell Ray I really like him too. Thanks, Judy. You totally don't have to tip. Like, I don't want this to be like anybody feeling weird or guilty for watching it. So, I mean, this is totally for free. And Corpus Christi, Texas, what's up, Mark? This is totally for free, so I don't want anyone to feel like weird about if you watch it and don't tip. So it's totally only if you want to. So cheers. It's more about bringing music to the people. Here we go. All right, thank you very much for the. Hey, Smidge.
Hey.
What the hell are you doing? So you're not.
No. I just wanted to make sure because she had no idea about the CO, the, whatever it's called, the virus or the. She's been sick.
All right. Well, talk to the thing because they can't hear you because of your little tiny voice. So if you're gonna say something.
What am I saying?
I don't know. Talk to them.
Hi. Was somebody asking me something?
Ask them.
Corpus Crispy. Somebody's from Corpus. Christy?
Yeah. Well, guys, let me know if you have any questions for Smidge so we can get her involved because she just keeps wandering off and...
She's trying to be productive.
So, any questions? Cassandra says hi.
Hi, Cassandra.
We're going to put more products... Yes, somebody said speak up, Smidge.
Speak up, Smidge.
Wow. Yes, we are going to put more products in the store. We have a store on, what is it on? Shopify. And, it's also, there's a link on my website, Shopify, Tim Sharone. So we're going to put a few more products in there, some more beachy stuff and some really cool stuff. What is it like being with a rock star? That's a good question.
Pretty awesome.
It's a pain in the ass. Let me tell you, she puts up with stuff you guys don't even want to know about. That's one of my favorite comments right there, Cassandra. You guys look great. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
So what is it? You should kind of maybe scoot up when you're talking. What is it like being with a rock star? That's me.
So I'm not going to be in the shot if I scoot up. That's the problem.
Yes, you are. You're just going
to scoot. You want me to go in front of you?
Scoot up, just scoot up there. Okay. And then there you go. My God, we can do anything right. With technology, bro. It's not a big deal. So, how hard is it to keep Tim in line?
Extremely.
We need more than one word answers. Dealing with schedules and his fame.
Well, since I'm my own boss, I can do whatever I want, so the schedule's not a problem. That's never been an issue. Because he has to deal with my schedule, so we make it work out. Right?
Yeah. What else? Anything else? What about dealing with my massive... fame in southern East Greenwich, Rhode Island.
I deal with that pretty well. I keep everybody at bay. There's security. Security, I'm security.
She's always, you know, what? Beating the girls off with a stick?
Exactly.
Yeah. Wow, you're on fire. Let's see. Yeah, we seem to compliment one another. Yeah, I do all the talking. you can just calm down.
No, I just it,
you don't have to.
You keep hitting me.
It's okay. So, yeah. Huh? Smidge.
I'm gonna go to the restroom real quick.
All right, Smidge is gonna go to the bathroom, and I'm gonna do this song. This is a favorite song of mine that was originally done by Van Morrison and then covered by John Mellencamp and Michelle Negrejanou. How do we keep the fire going? Ooh-wee. Pornhub? That's a real answer right there. Here we go. You asked. Had you
brush your shoes, you stand before the mirror, and you comb your hair, you grab your coat and hat, and you walk the streets, trying to remember the wild night's breeze through your mind. 'Cause everything looks so complete when you're walking out on the street. The wind, yeah, catches your feet and it sets you flying, crying. All the girls walk by, dressed up for each other. The boys do the boogie woogie on the corner of the street. The people passing by just stare with wild wonder. Yeah. Inside the jukebox rolls just like thunder. 'Cause everything looks so golden. Walking out.
No, for 3 months here for winter season. And you do live here?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. Good for you. Well, I'm jealous.
I'm Tim, and this is everybody watching online.
Oh, it's everybody watching live?
Yeah,
oh,
it's
nice.
Facebook Live.
Hi, guys.
So there's a neighbor. What a nice neighbor. Give me one sec. All right, all right, all right. Let's see. Here's one that you know. Oh, Cassandra, you've been to South Beach many years ago? Very cool. Everybody say hi to the neighbor. Hi, my friends. Hello from Everett, Mass. What's up, Ellie? It was 1989, my thoughts show, my hair was long, caught somewhere between a boy and man. She was 17 and she was far from in between. It was summertime in northern Michigan. Smashing through the
bottle, talking by the campfire. It's simple things in life like when and where. We didn't have no internet, man, I never will forget the way the moonlight shined upon our head. We were trying different things, we were smoking funny things, making love out by the lake to our favorite song. What's up, Donna? Whiskey out the bottle, not thinking about tomorrow, singing sweet old Alabama all summer long. Catch a walleye from the dock, watch the waves roll off the rocks. She'll forever hold a spot inside my soul. The blister in the sun, we couldn't wait for night to come. Hit that sand and play some rock and roll. Sure, my pleasure, Ellie. Trying different things, we were smoking funny things, making love out by the lake to our favorite song. Sipping whiskey out the bottle, not thinking about tomorrow, singing sweet old Alabama all summer long. Smidge! Sweet home Alabama, where the skies are so blue. Sweet home Alabama,
right. You're very welcome for cheering. It's my pleasure cheering y'all up. Smidge, what are you doing? Thank you very much, Laura. What are you doing?
What's going on out there?
I don't know. What is it?
I just heard some screaming. I just hope everybody's not coming this way.
Yeah, it's spring break here, and it gets really, really crazy. Smidge, we have a question for you.
Okay.
How did Smidge get her nickname?
How did I get my nickname? I think I'm always confused. I think you used to, I mean, I don't know if I can say it out loud because it's against little people.
Actually, somebody asked me how we keep the fire going between us. And I answered, Pornhub.
Yeah, that works really good. That's true.
We fire that
up a lot.
Yeah, fired up the couch today. This is really getting personal, isn't it?
Yeah.
I don't think there's really a story of how you got your nickname. I came up with her nickname because...
You'd just always be like, you're just a little... Because I'm not tall. I'm not...
She's...
Extremely short.
She's petite.
I'm petite.
She's precious in smell.
Thank you.
Look at it.
Hello.
Right?
Yes.
So, there you go. So, small, the other word is... Idjit with an M.
And there's a wine in Australia called Smidge. And apparently there's candies of some sort somewhere called Smidge.
Yeah.
It's a lot more popular than you think.
So that's how Smidge came about. It's basically something that I just came up with.
All by your little self, just like your songs. Huh. So proud of you.
I like my little songs.
I love your songs.
Did you
did drink it, didn't you?
Yeah.
Did somebody request to get with Azul, or you're not? You don't have that.
No, I don't have it here. Tim's lucky. Actually, no, I'm not.
I'm lucky. Thank you.
It's called skill.
It is skill. He has good skill.
Yeah, good skill. Yeah. All right, so what else do you guys want to talk about? Let me know what you want to talk about. or what do you want me to play?
I just had something. Oh, rock. Did you do Rockstar?
No.
You could do Rockstar, or does somebody here want to hear a cover?
Yeah, let us know. Let us know, and let us know what you're doing. I mean, is there you guys doing anything? Is everybody at home? Is everybody prepared? Is everybody like kind of stocked up and ready to go? How did we meet?
Tim was playing a gig in Key Largo, Florida at the Jimmy Johnson's Big Chill.
Yep.
And that's how we met. And he walked around with a piece of paper asking for email addresses. And you emailed me.
I only asked hot chicks
for
their email addresses. Like, dudes, I'm not going to ask for. Yeah.
I hope not.
See? Isn't that nice?
Very
see
nice
how nice thing. I am to Smidge? Ooh. Want to do it again? Smidge's favorite cover?
And you played Patience from...
Yes, so at Jimmy Johnson's Big Chill, it was one of my first gigs down there, right?
I think so, yeah.
I had played somewhere in Fort Lauderdale, and the owner or manager or something from Big Chill, it had just opened, so they brought me down to play in Key Largo. So I drove all the way. I was living in Miami Beach. I drove all the way down there to do my gigs. I was playing a duo gig with my friend Vic, and she was there. That's how we met.
And it was pretty hot.
Oh, thank you, dear. I got her with the song "Patience" by Guns N' Roses. So what's up, Betty? What's up, Betty Gordon?
Hey, oh, Betty, how are you?
Patience. I don't have patience. I have no patience.
He doesn't actually.
Yeah,
it's true.
Yeah.
That's
supposed to be nice to me. What
am I feeling? It's true.
If I had the printout for it, I could do it.
Is it in the other book? No, it wouldn't be in that. It would.
Yeah, I don't think I have it in there. All right, so what's up, Bill? How are you?
Hey, Bill.
All right, so let's... Hey, Betty, yes, we did. We met at Two Friends in Key West.
Yes, Two Friends, my favorite place to get a yellowtail sandwich.
Yeah, man.
Ever since I was a kid, actually, I would go there, get that.
Really?
Oh, yeah, love that yellowtail sandwich. Because they give it, like, with some sort of sauce with dill in it, like fresh dill.
Yeah. The Key West days.
Yeah. Oh my gosh. Do we have a song yet?
No, I don't
Can
think
I
we have a song.
One?
Yeah.
Rockstar?
Sure. Do I have the black book? Should be in there. So I'm gonna do a song that I wrote relatively recently, and we've been playing it in our sets, and it's a song about working hard for your dreams and surrounding yourself with people that really believe in what you're doing, and they believe in your dreams just as much as you do. And that's Smidge. So the song is, I think it's really cool because it's like a story song. So I love story songs, and I love writing story songs. So it has like three different sections of the story. It's like a movie. The first verse is the first scene, so it's like they're in a bar and they're poor and they're playing. I mean, it's just our story. They're playing, you know, for beer, and or he's just playing for beer, and they're really like betting on their whole life on him becoming a rock star someday. So it's like under a blinking bud neon sign, playing my heart out for an It should be right in one of the pages, in the plastic. So then the second verse is about started a band, we hit the open road, an old Chevy van that hated the snow. a million miles. So basically, he started a band and went on a little tour in a van, and she came with him. And the whole time, like, they're, you know, struggling and trying to achieve his dream of being a rock star. And of course, the chorus is, I'm going to be a rock star. Third. And then the third verse is...
Do you want to put it in third? You can see it?
Actually, yeah, just put it up here and I'll move this.
I'm gonna have to move the line.
The third verse is cheers. Cheers. The third verse is 10,000 lighters held high and strong. Listen to the crowd. They're singing my song, the one I wrote for you in that old beer bar. So the third verse is like, he's finally made it and now I'm a rock star. And
they did that the other night at Carnival.
Yeah. So at Carnival the other night when we played, it was absolutely magical. Thousands of people going absolutely crazy. It was super amazingly cool. And everybody put their lighters up, their flashlights on their phones up. So there was like a whole night was lit up, and it went right along with the song when it says 10,000 lighters held high and strong. So it was a magical moment, and
it was like a full moon night.
It was just, yeah, it was just like everything just worked. The vibe was incredible. Cheers, Susie. The vibe was incredible. The people were incredible. Susie was incredible.
Oh, Susie. Hey, yeah. Susie. Cheers. Empty.
Uh-oh.
Oh, you empty fast.
That's what I do. Mm. So, cheers. Yeah, Susie was there, and Ethan, and the Slaughters, and Rob helping out.
Oh, yeah.
Was amazing. Thank you so much, guys. Juan, of course, my band, so it was...
Sue Reynolds, a band from New England, flew all the way down.
Yes, that was very, very special to have her there. I don't want to forget the band. Mike, Everybody Loves Joey, Rhett, and Nelson. Just an amazing show, an amazing concert. And we want to thank everybody who was involved in getting us there, which is everybody from Carnival 2020, everybody from Calle Ocho, and everybody from the Kiwanis Club.
Some of the nicest people.
Yeah, amazing. Our new South Beach or Miami family, right?
Yes.
So here's Rockstar, and follow along with the little story in the three verses. Under a blinking bug neon sign, I'm playing my heart out for a nickel and dime. A warm draft for me, for you, some cheap white wine. Bang it all on me, sing these rhymes. I'm gonna be a rock star, rolling Sunset Boulevard. Going wild and running free, VIP. Paparazzi, gold guitars, ring down Rolls Royce, brand new cars. Blood, sweat, tears, take us far. Oh, I will know who we are. Gonna be a rock star. Started a band, we hit the open road. That old Chevy van. Hit the snow, a million miles or more with you by my side. I'm telling you, girl, it's just a matter of time. Can you read the comments?
Okay.
I'm gonna be a rock star, rolling Sunset Boulevard.
Sounds great.
Young, wild, and
rolling. Oh, Mike Camacho said, hey,
VIP,
Mike.
Baby,
call you tomorrow.
Oh, I will know who we are. Gonna be a rock star. Oh, you're very welcome, Bill. Thank you for being such a great VIP fan. We appreciate you. So this is basically the scene from Saturday night, right? So we'll set the stage, set the scene. So this is the verse where the person makes it and is playing these huge shows after playing these little dive bars for years and years and years.
True story.
Man. Wow. I sang for my supper. I sang for our supper.
That's
many
when I
years.
Learned what meet and threes were in Nashville or in Tennessee. Had no idea what that was.
Yeah.
And if you don't know what that is, look it up.
Yeah, it's basically grapefruit. But I would go out and I would play just for dinner and tips, and the places would feed both of us, which was very nice. And then I graduated to playing for, what's up, Donna from Bama?
Bama.
I graduated to playing like $25 gigs at Rockstar Bar,
yeah.
For 3 hours.
That
and
doesn't
we would,
exist anymore.
We would have to carry all the equipment up the hills in downtown Nashville.
In the cold.
In the freezing, bitter cold, man. Like the wind, so bad. And it was, oh, and then Columbia, remember Columbia?
Yep. Oh, we used to get free steak dinner.
Free steak dinner.
Free steak dinner.
Yeah, and $45.
And we were so excited about that.
We were
that.
So excited about those gigs because it was impossible to get gigs. Anyway, so this song is real. This song is from our real life. Oh, thank you, Ray and Jody. We appreciate it. Stay safe, stay healthy, guys. Thanks for hanging with us. All right, so here's the verse that we lived out on Saturday night. 10,000 lighters held high and strong. Listen to the crowd singing my song. The one I wrote for smidgen that old bear bar. It's crazy how we've come this far. 'Cause now I'm a rock star. Rolling Sunset Boulevard. Young, wild, and running. VIP, baby, you and me. Flashbulbs, paparazzi, gold guitars. Laying down Rolls Royce, brand new cars. Blood, sweat, and tears, it took us far. The whole wide world knows who we are. 'Cause I'm a freaking rock star. Rolling Sunset Boulevard. Young, wild, and running free. VIP. Paparazzi, gold guitars. Laying down Rolls Royce, brand new cars. Blood, sweat, and tears took us far. The whole wide world knows who we are. 'Cause I'm a freaking rock star. 'Cause I'm a freaking rock star. And this is how we ended the show the other night. And this is how we're gonna end it tonight. So thank you all very much for watching. Drop a tip in the digital tip jars if you would like, and please make sure that you share this post.
Yeehaw.
Thank you, Smidge. Say goodbye, Smidge.